Hi, in this video you will learn how to create this beautiful pick and stick animated photo collage in PowerPoint. Now the reason why I call this as pick and stick photo collage template is it is easy for us to replace any of these pictures. For example, if I want to replace this with some other image, I select this and hit delete. Now you see that this is a picture placeholder. So I can always go to insert, go to pictures and pick up from the stock images or from one of the images that you already have on your computer. Here I am picking up something from the stock images and I can have anything. For example, I can have this lady in the center and say insert. Now in a matter of seconds, that picture gets downloaded, cropped in a circle and is placed right in the center. The same way, if I want to replace this with some other image, I can select this and hit delete. Once again, I can go to insert, pictures, stock images, and I can choose any of the images. Maybe this one is a good one and I can say insert. Now you can see the new image, which is cropped in a proper shape, is now inserted and it replaces the earlier one. So it is that easy for you to work with this photo collage template. So let us learn how to create this template, and in doing so, you will understand the basic behind creating any photo collage template using picture placeholders. By the way, I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. We share creative PowerPoint ideas to help professionals like you create engaging presentations. Now, let us recreate the template. Here I am on a new presentation. I'm going to choose a simple blank layout. First, let me go to Auto Shapes Gallery, pick up a rectangle tool, and then draw a thin rectangular bar like this. Now, the reason why I've chosen this rectangular bar is to create the space between the various photos. And let us have this right in the center. So I have selected this. We can go to align and say align middle. So you can see that it is right here. Now I'm going to make a copy of this by pressing Ctrl D. And we are going to rotate this vertically. So go to rotate and say rotate right 90 degrees. And we are going to have this right in the center again. So once again, go to align and this time you say align center. Now we've got everything placed the right way. Then we are also going to have a circle which will be around this. So let us go to Auto Shapes Gallery once again. From basic shapes, let us pick up the oval tool. Now to create a circle which is properly placed, I'm going to hold the Control and Shift button and I'm going to draw like this, and it becomes much easier for me to get an idea of what is the size of this circle. And you can see it expands from the center and it's not expanding from the corners as it usually happens. And that is because I have held both Control and Shift button while I am drawing the circle. Now that looks pretty nice. Now the next step is to make another copy of this by pressing Ctrl D, and let us have this in a different color. Maybe we can have orange color. The color doesn't really matter at this point. We are going to have this placed right on top of the previous one. Yeah, this looks good. Now once again, let us hold Ctrl and Shift and then click and drag from the corner, and you can see that this is now a smaller circle, but we are able to resize it just the right way we want from the center. Now this looks beautiful. Now with these elements to guide us, we are going to create our photo collage template. Let me select all of these elements. So let me press Ctrl A and that selects everything, and let me press Ctrl C. So I have got that available in my clipboard. Now let me go to Slide Master by going to View, Slide Master. And here we have a whole bunch of layouts. I'm going to create a new layout. So let me insert that anywhere here. So I'm going to right click here and say insert a new layout. And I don't really require any of these elements. So let me select all of these and delete them. Now I'm going to stick whatever that I already have in the clipboard by pressing Ctrl V. And this guide is available for me to create my template. Now this one I can rename. So I can go to rename layout and say photo collage. Now let us create a rectangle which will be in this space here. We are going to leave these blue gutters out. So let us go to insert placeholder, and I'm going to have this as a picture. You click on it, and by clicking and dragging from the corner, you can create this shape here. Now that looks perfect. You can see that the dimensions are matching the area that I want. I have left out the gutter. Here I can see that I need to make a little bit of adjustment. So I have pushed it up. Now that is perfect. I'm going to make a duplicate of this by pressing Ctrl D, and then let me place this to this side here. Press Ctrl D again, and then let us place this at the bottom right corner. Now let me press Ctrl D again, and let me place this over here. Now with these rectangular picture placeholders in place, it is time for us to create the circle in the middle. Once again, let us go to Insert Placeholder, go to Picture, and then place your cursor in the center, and then hold Ctrl and Shift so you can draw a square. Holding the Shift button allows you to have your shape constrained in proportions. So you've created a square, and you can see that the dimensions now are matching the outer circle, that is the blue circle. Now this looks good, so let me leave that out. Now we have got our square, but it needs to be in a circular shape. How do we do that? It's very simple. Go to Home, then go to Shape Format, go to Edit Shape, go to Change Shape, and from Basic Shapes, choose the circle. You have edited the square into a proper circle. Now, to just check if everything is right, we can move this and you can see that it's a perfect circle. So let me press Ctrl Z. Now we have created this proper circle in the middle. Now to differentiate this circular picture from the surrounding pictures, I want to give this a thick white outline. For that, let me go to Shape Outline and choose White Outline. And then go to Shape Outline again, go to Weight, and you can choose 6 points. And you can see that we have got a thick outline here. We can delete everything. So let me press this blue here, delete, press this blue here, delete, and then select this, and probably that has selected the picture placeholder. Yeah, it is so. Now I'm going to press Ctrl X so it is cut. So that allows me to select all these ones and delete, and then press Ctrl V so I can bring it back in place. Now we have got our picture placeholders in place. Let me go to Close Master View. Now let me insert a new slide with the layout that we just created. So let me go to Insert New Slide. And the layout that we want is this one called as Photo Collage, because that is the custom one that we created just now. Let me select that, and it is available here. First, let me select the central one. So let me select this and then go to Insert Pictures Stock Images, and let us choose some picture. Let me go down and I'm going to select this tiger and insert. Let us select this, and this time I'm going to select something which I've already stored. So let me select this and say insert. Let me select this by clicking on the picture icon, and let me choose some other picture and insert, and do the same for this one as well. I'm just rushing through this. It's very, very simple. You go here and let me choose some other picture and insert. So we've got all the pictures laid out properly. It is time for us to apply custom animation. So let me go to animations, go to animation pane so you can follow what I'm going to do. The center one is going to first enter. So let me choose a simple zoom animation for the center one. And after that, let us select this first, hold the shift button down, select this, 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 and all of them need to appear as a simple fade. So let us have this fade and say after previous. So when I go to slideshow, you can see on a click, we have the center one zooming in, and then the remaining ones appear, and we have a beautiful picture collage. And as I mentioned earlier, at any point you want to replace any of these photos, it is a matter of just clicking it, deleting it. By going to pictures, stock images, you can always pick another picture to replace it. Maybe I can choose this lady as we had done earlier and say insert. Now we have the lady in the center surrounded by these various beautiful images of flowers. The only caveat here is you may have to reapply the custom animation. If you don't want to apply custom animation every single time, you can always go to View Slide Master, and you can go to this template, and you can have this selected and have this available as a zoom animation. So let me go here and have that as zoom animation. And then we have each of these coming one after another, like the way that we did earlier, fade, and all of these happens after previous. And instead of appearing on click, I can have the first one as with previous. Now this is an animated template. I can always go back to Slide Master and close it. Now when I insert a new slide with that layout, like in this case photo collage, when I select this and then insert a picture, let us select any picture at random, maybe this one, and say insert. When I go to slideshow, you can see that animation is already inbuilt, so that saves you even more time. Pictures and animation is a potent combination that will hold the attention of even the most distracted audience. If you want to know how to use picture animation in PowerPoint like a pro, we have put together a short playlist of videos which you can refer to by clicking on the link here. All you need to do is to click on the link and start watching the videos one after another and gain expertise in working with picture animations in PowerPoint. So go ahead, click on the link here and start watching the videos right now.